So graphene is essentially the building blocks of graphite. If you strip away a layer of graphite, what you essentially get is graphene. So it's a single atom thick. It's completely made of carbon atoms, so it has a huge surface area. You get incredible properties. So compared to its size, graphene strength is phenomenal. It has a huge tensile strength. It's very elastic. It's almost a perfect barrier. It doesn't let any materials through, not even gases. It's also incredibly electrically and thermally conductive. Companies are now able to make graphene at the ton scale. Generally, they make this using what we call a top-down approach. So they'll take graphite and they'll exfoliate it. So they'll process it or mill it to separate those layers of graphene from the bulk graphite material. You could also make graphene from different recycled materials, so polymer waste or wood char, biomass. There's a big area of interest in making graphene materials from more sustainable routes. The Graphene Engineering Innovation Centre, or the GEIC, so we're part of the University of Manchester, but we're very much an industrial centre within the university. We don't do fundamental research here, we don't have students. Everything we do is industry-led. We work with some big companies. We do collaborative projects with them, which are all completely funded by industry. But the idea is that we bridge that gap between what's been done at the university on an academic, on a lab scale, to what industry needs, which is pilot production, prototypes, all moving towards pushing commercialization of graphene products. The potential applications for graphene are vast. Here at the centre, we have maybe six main areas that we work on, and these are coatings and membranes. In this case, we're looking at the barrier properties of graphene and the strength properties. We have composites, so that's anything from carbon fibre systems to thermosetting plastics. And again, that's all down to strength enhancement of physical properties of the material. We do some work with printing and inks. We can use those printed sensors or printed electronics onto different substrates. We have energy, so you can use graphene in batteries due to its electrical properties. We also have the construction department, so there's a huge interest at the minute in using graphene in construction because it can give really enhanced mechanical properties. The challenges for us application users is that we need graphene to behave in a very specific way depending on the product that we're putting it in. There are lots of different grades of graphene and they behave differently in different materials. Graphene is a relatively new material. It's only been around for 20 years. It's taken time to build up that supply chain, get that reproducible sourcing of graphene. And it's for that reason that we're only just now seeing graphene products come into the market. They need to be tested. They need to be formulated. With a new material, you can't rush into putting something in the market without thoroughly testing it and having that supply chain to support it. So right now we're seeing an explosion of different graphene products in the markets, from automotive coatings to composites to carbon fiber structures, and it's a really emerging technology. One of the challenges of working with graphene is that it can be very tricky to formulate with and to disperse. In particular, it doesn't like being in water-based formulations. It has a tendency to agglomerate, naturally wants to go back to its graphitic state and restack. It's very important for us to use high shear systems, such as the Silverson, to get that energy into the system so we can get graphene dispersed well throughout a formulation or a product. If it's not dispersed, you just will not get the end properties that you need because it's a very, very small amount. We can look at it through microscopy and we can see that you do not get that level of dispersion with standard lab style mixers that you do with the Silverson system. We have a range of equipment here. So we have the smallest lab Silversons. We have some intermediate systems. Some of the big projects that we had on, we required almost a ton of formulation. It just wasn't feasible to use the smaller systems for what we needed. We've recently purchased the big Silverson batch mixer system. So that's taken our production time right down from several days to a few hours. That's completely changed how we can work with our partners and how we can provide large scale samples for them. Most of the people who work in the GEIC, like myself, have come from industry because we bring that kind of production and scale-up experience that we need to translate that science into industry. And most of us have always used Silverson mixers. It's a reputational thing. It's the mixer you use if you need a good high shear system. And that's why we have so many on site here. We can use Silverson throughout the whole process of making a new product at the GEIC. It's not just about dispersing graphene in water or solvents. We can use it for every step. If we took coatings as an example, we use the high shear dispersant all the way through, straight from putting the graphene in to putting the pigments, the dispersants, all the resin systems as well. And it's also used across the application areas. One of the main benefits is that we can scale up directly from the smaller mixers to the bigger mixers. And we've tested that, and we know that the Silverson systems are reliable and versatile throughout the whole process.